Welcome to InfOT. Today, we will talk about the Astronaut Training Protocol that occupational therapists use. Astronaut Training was created by Mary Kawar, Sheila Freak, and Ron Freak, and was inspired by the training that real astronauts go through before going out into space. They need specific training to live in zero gravity, and their vestibular systems need to reprogram to adapt to the new environment. Astronaut Training Protocol is an intervention that targets our visual, vestibular, and auditory systems. The vestibular system manages our balance, motion, and tells us where our body is in space. The vestibular system works closely with two other very important systems, the auditory and the visual. These systems, altogether, give us all the information we need to move and keep our balance and orientation in space. The Astronaut Training Protocol seems to train these systems and helps individuals with sensory processing difficulties. The program is effective for people of all ages, from infants to adults. Infants and toddlers may need some help with the safe positioning. Astronaut training is meant to be used at the beginning of the session in order to optimize the therapeutic benefits from the activities that follow. First, a trained occupational therapist uses preparatory exercises that enable our vestibular system. For example, such exercises include games on a yoga ball, bowling, spinning, rolling, and more. These activities are meant to be fun and appealing to the client. Then, the therapist spins the client on a board in a sitting and then in a lying position. At the same time, the client listens to the astronaut program soundtracks. Moving on, the client engages in a series of eye-tracking activities for the visual system and promotes it to work with our vestibular system. According to the creators of the program, the therapist needs to gradually increase input when working with the protocol. 1 or 2 times per day is the recommended frequency. When the therapist sees progress, then the frequency and intensity is gradually decreased. So, does it work? Research is very limited on this subject, and it includes mostly some case studies presenting slight changes in the vestibular, visual, auditory systems. Improvements were also found in postural control, balance, in-seat movement, and overall arousal level. All information in this video was found here. Thank you for watching InfoT. If you like this video, feel free to like and subscribe. Stay tuned for more.